Welcome to 100 Hours, 100 Stars. Over the course of the next 100 hours, we're making you meet 100 stars from various walks of life. And this particular next star is very special to me. Not only is he a friend, he's somebody who's battling the COVID-19 virus on the front line. But before that, on the screen, you'll see a QR code and a link. You could either use the QR code or click on the link. Scan the QR code. It'll open up a contribution page to the PM CARES Fund, the Prime Minister CARES Fund, or you could click on the link. Fill out the amount, your payment details, and then click proceed to contribute and contribute. This is for our medical health practitioners, the Prime Minister CARES Fund. Dr. Muffy, as his friends know him, Muffazal Lakdawala, really a hero in this battle against COVID-19. Hi, how are you? Thank you for joining me on this, and lots of sleepless nights, eh?
Yes, it's been quite a journey, but most of the journals have written this is a war and I'm right on the forefront and I'm glad I am there, because how is it possible to sleep when the rest of the world is burning? How is it possible to just not do anything as a doctor when there are so many people who are dying?
That's a very, very noble thing, thought. Now, the NSCI, the National Sports Club of India, the Dome Stadium, houses 8,000 to 10,000 people. It's been a concert venue. I saw One Republic there. It has been venues for badminton tournaments and kabaddi tournaments. And now you've turned it into a state-of-the-art 500 people bed quarantine facility as well as diagnostic center. Take us through this remarkable story, Dr. Muffy.
You know, I never thought I'd probably turn a rock stadium into a facility where we are going to save millions of lives. And I'm so glad we've managed to do that. So it's come to real use for us. We knew that we would have the large numbers coming in. And I was very happy to work with an equally dynamic team of the Municipal Commissioner of G-South, Mr. Sharad Ubre. And we've had ample backing from the Bombay Municipal Commissioner, Mr. Parveen Pardeshi, as well as Mr. Aditya Thakre, who's the MLA for Worli. So it's been great going. They've backed me all the way. And I've kind of tried and brought about a medical team, which has got a few doctors along with me, as well as I've got a few physiotherapists, all volunteers. So I've put a note out and said, whoever wants to join me in this journey and battle, please come on. And they've all gladly joined me.
Muffy, your finger. Your finger is on the camera. Yeah. The only concept?
The only concept that I wanted to do out over here very clearly was that not only ensure that the patients were kept safe, and that was my main goal, but also to ensure that all the healthcare professionals who had stuck their neck out and had put their onus and trust on me to save them through this journey were equally well looked after. So therefore, we thought of a contactless clinic, wherein there would be minimal contact, if any, between the doctor as well as the patient. So we've got these screens and everything that demarcates the doctor. Normally, when in a COVID ward, you'd see a doctor going in. He has the hazmat suit. He's sweating. There's a lot of problem. And barely do you get time to really discuss anything with the patient. What this contactless clinic has allowed us is to safely sit in the confines of an AC room with a HEPA filter with us so that we are not 100% sure we won't get infected. At the same time, give as much time as we can to the patient to answer all his queries. They come one by one. We've got now 385 patients, all COVID positive with us. And we start consulting in the morning at around 8. They all go on board. And it's quite a pleasurable experience. Initially, it was difficult because once in a while, we go in, we touch our patients, we feel our patients in the sense that we give them a hug when they're really down. And that really gets them on board. And now they've got used to this episode of coming and seeing us through the screen. It was a learning experience for us, but it's worked really well. And I'm so glad we did this. We have periods during the day for 1 or 2 hours during the morning and evening when all the patients come out. And they do perform yoga in the sun. They have their moment in the sun. And they're enjoying this facility.
Your hand is on the camera again. I can see your hand, your finger. You also did something really spectacular for all the inhabitants of this quarantine facility. You got Roop Kumar Rathod to sing for them. How remarkable was that? That seems like out of a film, but it actually happened. Tell us about that.
Yeah, so Rupji is a close friend, and I told him that I want to do something which picks up the morale of these people, because what I've seen is a lot of this is about stigmatization. The moment someone's declared as positive, the BMC officials, as they have to, come and surround it, quarantine the people around them, and then it becomes like an entire stigma thing that plays out. It's almost as if you're a terrorist and you're hunted down, right? And that's unfortunate. So if people, even healthcare workers who are working, are not allowed to go back. So I thought, how do I boost their morale? They're all confined in this room. They come out for a couple of hours every day. So I thought I'd bring out the stars who they love, they adore, and tell them to come out and give a positive message. So we've had Roop Kumar Rathod, Sonali Rathod, come out and say, this is for the NSA. We brought up the morale. We've had a great talk with them, all in Marathi, so that they could, you know, identify with them. They're having lots more people. Anu Malik has done this for us. Then very soon we are going to have Sachin, who's going to come in and do a bit for us before we play Sachin the movie. We're going to have Salman to come and do a bit. So I'm asking all stars to come out and do their bit for these guys out here, because just a few kind words from some of these big stars can make such a huge difference for these people.
Now, this is really one of the most sensitive zones in Mumbai city. We're talking the Worli and the Prabhadevi area, in particular Worli village, which a lot of people have, were red zoned very early on. So talk about how they come in, how the testing happens. I've even seen some visuals of hands going through holes in the glass and doctors getting swabs done, and conversations happening through a intercom facility. So all the facilities you have, and how are you testing asymptomatic patients also, or only symptomatic ones, all those things?
So we are basically a CCC2 facility, which treats basically mild to moderately symptomatic patients, right? We don't really have the serious ones here. And we are in the process of setting up a 40-bedded ICU. We are setting up a tent. So this will become a proper hospital in the next week or so. Yeah, where we'll be treating all kinds. But for now, we are treating the mild to moderately symptomatic patients. Like I said, the minimal contact is maintained. We use phone calls to talk to the patient across, because if you have a loudspeaker, then that conversation is no longer private, because we have four patients that we screen at the same time. These cubicles that you would have seen of large gloves going out and stressing, because when a person's throat swab is taken, if a patient coughs, that aerosol can infect the doctor. So this kind of prevents the doctor. We are also having a safe clinic set up, a fever clinic, which has again got negative pressure here. So we've got a lot of exciting stuff happening in this. Today morning, the health minister of Maharashtra, the municipal commissioner, and Aditya Thackeray, launched the first mobile bus clinic, which is a bus which has a digital X-ray. We're using artificial intelligence to figure out which patients are in the high-risk category, and then we swab those patients, because it's not humanly possible to swab everyone in a slum. So we'll take this bus to the slums and get in 500 patients, let's say, per day, screen them. If their X-rays pick up a high or moderate risk, we will evaluate whether they need to be swabbed. And if they need to be swabbed, we'll move them into a quarantine zone till their swab comes negative or positive. If it comes positive, they move into the isolation. If it's negative, they go back home.
So you send the test swabs to a nearby pathology lab, or do you send it to Kasturba Gandhi Hospital? How does that work?
So far, we've tied up with Reliance Life Sciences, and we are doing our swabs there. But very soon, we'll have our own RT-PCR lab. So as we speak, within a week, we'll have our own RT-PCR lab, and we should have no problems with that. We're trying to capacity of testing 600 samples a day.
That's wonderful. So I take it the bus has all the, you said you're even doing X-rays there. Are you doing some X-rays in the bus? Yeah.
X-rays turned out as a great tool. All right. So far we had only RT-PCR and we had the rapid test. Now rapid test didn't really burn themselves out, because the results were not really that great. So what we've realized is X-ray has turned out as a powerful tool to predict those who around the sixth, 7 day after coming in contact with a high-risk patient, and if they are going to turn positive, we have clear-cut signs on X-rays that can tell us that this patient is going towards COVID. Or if a patient has COVID, we are using the X-ray to monitor how worse this patient will become. So let's say a patient's going to worsen, we would use these facilities for that. We don't need a CT scan and ultrasound, though they are better modalities. It's not humanly possible to do a CT or an ultrasound in most patients. So X-ray is a safe, cheap, and effective tool for mass screening.
What about the antibodies versus PCR argument? You know, some people said, you know, the antibodies one is more feasible. Others say the PCR is more feasible.
The PCR is a test which turns positive around the fourth to fifth day after you've been exposed. It's the most ideal test right now. It's got the least false negative results. The antibody tests are, you're looking for immunoglobulin M, which is usually positive around the 8th to 10th day after infection. So you might miss the early phase. And IgG turns positive around the 15th day. Yeah. And the rapid kits that we have not really been that useful. So when we do a rapid test, we get a false sense of bravado saying that we are negative when you might actually be positive. So RT-PCR is the gold standard today as we speak. But X-ray is fast emerging as the new modality, which might really help us in mass screening at least.
So your facility is absolutely free of cost, is it?
It's completely free of cost. Yeah. Wow. This is completely free of cost. And this is done on BMC funds and a bit of CSR funds.
That's wonderful. So each bed is given a fan. Are there water points, toilets? Speak about the facilities. What is their food rationing like? All of that, please.
So we've got fans. Every bed does not have a fan, but we've got fans. We've got the dome, as you know, is an AC facility. Now, there is a lot of misgiving about whether having AC can. Now, we are running a facility which has got all positive patients. Now, in an all positive facility, it's difficult for the AC to spread the infection around. If you have some positive, some negative, then you can't have centralized AC. Yeah. But otherwise, this is a good enough facility for everybody. So we've got the AC. It helps them in times right now when it's very, very hot. We also have facilities wherein we have something which is lying on the bed of the patient, which we are trying out, which are sensors which bring me the heart rate, the pulse rate, the blood pressure, the oxygen saturation, and the blood sugar onto my computer screen. So if this model is successful, we will be able to manage patients at home without actually the patients coming in into these facilities.
Is it a wrist sensor?
It's like an iPhone with a sensor, and it gives me all the parameters that I need to monitor. So I can have you in a hotel, let's say, if I have you in a Four Seasons, you can live and stay there properly. At the same time, I can safely monitor you from the reception.
Are we really flattening the curve? Actually, finish that part about the food. How are you getting the patients to food? And then we'll come to the flattening the curve. So food in the facility.
BMC has been kind enough to provide food. We get a lot of people to provide biscuits and tea. Tea is provided twice a day. There are enough of food packets that last. Fruits are given to these patients. Then they're given hair oil. They're given toothpaste. They're given the works. So actually, they're very, very well looked after. The bathrooms, they've made sure that there are enough and adequate bathrooms inside. So NSCI Dome has been transformed into a facility which probably hosts right now 50 or 60 toilets, as well as around 50 or 60 showers.
And what are you doing for medicines? Are you tied up with pharmacies? Is the BMC providing that too? What are you doing with the medicines?
So certain drugs like HCQS, which we use for some of these patients, so empirically we are still using it. Azithromycin, that's right now controlled by the government bodies. So we get that through the BMC. Certain other drugs we've tied up with pharmacies in Burley, which directly provide them to us. So we're pretty okay with that.
You know, at one end of the spectrum, we are hearing that the state government is preparing for over 75K cases to hit us by the end of May, which is why there's a facility coming up at the Goregaon Exhibition Center, other areas. And then, you know, there are reports of, because we're testing so much in Maharashtra, that's why the cases are so high, and it's not really that bad. How are we doing in terms of flattening the curve? When will things get better? These are all questions that all average citizens have, Dr. Mufi.
So, you know, Mumbai being the one city which actually has maximum number of people going in and out of the country, right? So it was bound to get hit like any major city in the world. quite unlike the interiors of India. Luckily, we have not been hit there. It's got one of the best medical facilities and everything. Unfortunately, the other end of Mumbai is the underbelly, which is the slums. We probably have the largest pocket of slums. And once it gets into the slum with people using common washrooms and with hardly any sunlight going even between rooms, people like a 10 square feet room sharing, 10 people sharing that room, it's almost impossible for anyone, however much technologically advanced you are or however gifted you are, to prevent to get social distancing there and to prevent migration of this coronavirus. So I think the government's done a great job with testing enough people. So what they're doing right now is the BMC is trying to test as many people as they can and pick up the ones who are in very close contact and then try and quarantine them. Those who are testing positive are isolated. We do know, like the Honorable Chief Minister has said, that 80% of our cases are asymptomatic or mildly symptomatic. And we are actually catching hold of these 80 or 70. So though the numbers might look really large right now, I think we've done a great job to probably prevent as many deaths as would have happened if they wouldn't have done these things. As a doctor, I can say that.
So what is your advice to anybody who's listening? How can we continue the good job self-isolating ourselves? Because the virus doesn't normally spread through the air unless you're in close proximity of a symptomatic person who sneezes or coughs in front of you. Otherwise, it's surface-driven, isn't it?
Yeah, so one thing is that what a message I'd like to give people is don't stigmatize those who've got the virus. If they've improved and come in, they might be actually, their blood or their plasma might actually land up point saving your life. So if you stigmatize them today, remember that your turn might come tomorrow. So please don't do that. The next thing is, you want to be safe, stay at home, try and let as many people who venture out and not come in inside your safe house. You are as safe at home. This virus does not spread in the air. So if somebody in the opposite building has got the virus, don't worry. You're definitely not going to get this virus. Okay, so let's get fear out first. The only way you can get this virus is if someone brings that virus into your home and you are not careful with washing your hands enough, or you touch surfaces that person's touched. So even if someone who's got the virus and is asymptomatic comes to your house, make sure that you've got a sterilium or a sanitizer left at the doorstep, and make sure that person uses it. If you've got people to go out and procure food and groceries for you, make sure that is washed thoroughly with water, and that person before entering the house again uses this adequate care before coming into the house. I think
if you're ordering in, then would you advise heating the food apart from cleaning it down?
Remember that when the virus goes in through your digestive tract, the acid in your stomach is good enough to kill this virus. So you don't really ingest this virus and get the virus. You can inhale this virus. You can touch this virus to your nasal mucosa. You can touch it to your eyes. And that's how you can get this virus. Otherwise, through the oral route, I think the chances are extremely, extremely minuscule.
So, you know, the economy is suffering. A lot of people want to get back to work. But at the same time, we know that there is an active threat if we do get back to work. So what is your estimate right now? I mean, we are going to definitely go into the month of June with this as of now, because it's not showing any signs of subsiding, at least in the month of May. Do you imagine that we're in this for the long haul, like Wuhan, perhaps go on for another 6 months? Or do you see light at the end of the tunnel in about three?
I'm very proud that our Prime Minister has taken the call of shutting down India. You know, it's a huge call, and I get the pressures on him would have been immense, of shutting down 1.3 billion people with different races, different people, different sensibilities, poor, rich, all inclusive. But I think we've probably prevented a mass destruction in India by that shutdown. Now the question is, how soon do we open? And I'm not an economist. I'm a healthcare provider. I know only how to save lives. So I would leave it as to how to get the economy back on track with people who know how to get it back on track. My job is to save lives. I think this will last for another month, month and a half is my take on this virus before we start seeing the numbers going down in India, just because of the number of people we have and because there is going to be migration of people going into the villages and stuff like that. We'll have to be careful about that fact. But I think kudos to those people in power who've taken the tough decision of shutting this country down. And I think we've saved a lot of lives.
And in that aspect, you know, given that, like you said, you know, migrant workers moving in and out and things like that, as far as you are concerned, this has been a very, very intense phase for you. If and when the lockdown is ever lifted on the lighter side, what is the first thing that you will do as a healthcare professional?
I have stayed away from my wife and my son for far too long. Wow. I sleep on the couch in my clinic. The first thing I'd probably go and do is give them a tight hug. I'd play a little bit of football with my son and then probably get back to my surgeries, what I'm actually used to doing.
What you're actually used to doing, that's right. So, and the entire team of Dr. Muffazal's Digestive Health Institute is there with you at the facility?
Digestive Health Institute has become my new. I sleep there. I use it just for sleeping. I come around 1 or 2 at night and I leave at 7 in the morning. So there are 4 or 5 hours of sleep. And that too intermittently, I'll get calls that a patient needs a dialysis, stranded, where can we shift him? Can you please take him just for the night and save him and then we move else? So I don't think I've gathered 4 or 5 hours of sleep at a stretch. And now with Ramadan being there, I'm finding it even more difficult. But it's all working out. So as long as the fight is on, it's good.
When you take the bus into slums so far, I mean, these are very early days. But what are you hearing from other people who have mobile testing units? Are slum dwellers open to being tested or they're resisting it? Or have they finally come to their senses and realized that this is an active threat?
See, the fear. Everybody's realized that corona is a big threat. It's not like a common flu. People are willing to get tested. People are not necessarily willing to get quarantined for 14 days. Yes, that's a problem. But what we've done with this is now we are testing those high-risk populations in these slums on the 7th or 14th day. And if the x-rays are good, then we are okay. If the x-rays show some signs of COVID, we are swabbing them and we're getting them out so that they don't infect more people. So I think this x-ray surveillance might really help us solve the problem.
Guys, 100 hours, 100 stars is about stars like Dr. Muffazal Lakdawala. There's a QR code and there's a link. All you have to do is scan it or click on the link and fill in the amount you want to donate, feed in your payment details, and a donation is made to the Prime Minister CARES Fund, the PM CARES Fund, and that will go a long way in our battle against COVID-19. Dr. Muffy, love you lots. Thank you on behalf of the city of Mumbai, Maharashtra and India for all the wonderful work that you and your colleagues are doing, and big virtual hugs to you.
Thank you and stay safe. Yeah, I'll hug you in person next time you meet.
Take care. Bye.
Hey, hi, this is RJ Yash from Fever FM Hyderabad, and I hope you're enjoying 100 Hours with 100 Stars. The list is great. We have got legends, we have got superstars, so just stay tuned. And if you like what you see, please do like, share, comment, and subscribe our social handles, and just stay safe.
जब सारी दुनिया कर रही थी बकवास, तब फीवर वॉइस ऑफ चेंज की शुरुआत करते हुए रेडियो पर जॉन अब्राहम, गौतम गंभीर और वरुण धवन ने मिलकर ये कहा।
हाय, मैं हूँ गौतम गंभीर।
हाय, मैं हूँ वरुण धवन।
हाय, मैं हूँ जॉन अब्राहम।
फीवर वॉइस ऑफ चेंज के साथ मैं कहता हूँ, बकवास बंद,
बदलाव शुरू।
फीवर वॉइस ऑफ चेंज का सबसे पहला इनिशिएटिव था नो MC, नो BC।
मैं जॉन अब्राहम कहता हूँ,
मैं वरुण धवन भी ये वादा करता हूँ,
हम अपने शहर की औरतों को जुबान से इज्जत देंगे,
यानी नो MC, नो BC।
उसके बाद मिशन तेजाब में कई एसिड अटैक विक्टिम्स की जिंदगी का रुख बदल दिया।
हाय, मैं हूँ आमिर खान और फीवर वॉइस ऑफ चेंज एसिड अटैक विक्टिम्स को एक नई जिंदगी दे रहा है, मैं इसका स्वागत करता हूँ।
मिशन जुर्रत में देश के सारे पुलिस डिपार्टमेंट्स को एक साथ मिलकर कहा।
नमस्कार, मैं अमिताभ बच्चन बोल रहा हूँ। दिल्ली, बेंगलोर, कोलकाता और मुंबई पुलिस को बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं मैं देना चाह रहा हूँ। आप फीवर 104 FM मिशन जुर्रत का हिस्सा बने हैं। ये बदलाव की बहुत बड़ी शुरुआत है और मेरी शुभकामनाएं आपके साथ।
जब कश्मीर में फ्लड्स आए, लाखों की तादाद में खाने पीने की सामग्री कश्मीर भिजवाई, हमारी इस कोशिश के लिए मिशन कश्मीर ने जीता गोवा फेस्ट में प्रेस्टीजियस एबी अवार्ड।
मैं और आप मिलकर फीवर वॉइस ऑफ चेंज का अगला प्रोजेक्ट शुरू करते हैं, ब्लड बैंक 104। ब्लड बैंक 104 फीवर वॉइस ऑफ चेंज के साथ मैं जॉन अब्राहम ये वादा करता हूँ कि इस शहर में जब भी होगी खून की दरकार, तैयार रहेगा फीवर 104।
और फिर ट्रैफिक जाम की वजह से नहीं जाए कोई जान, उसके लिए हमने शुरू की अपनी मुहिम एम्बुलेंस फर्स्ट।
हाय मैं हूँ जॉन इब्राहिम।
हाय मैं हूँ गौतम गंभीर।
हाय मैं वरुण धवन बोल रहा हूँ।
हाय मैं हूँ आलिया भट्ट।
जब भी एम्बुलेंस का सायरन सुनाई दे तो हो जाए लेफ्ट, क्योंकि एम्बुलेंस फर्स्ट।
अब बकवास बंद, बदलाव शुरू।
एम्बुलेंस फर्स्ट के साथ साथ फीवर वॉइस ऑफ चेंज ने जिम्मा लिया ऑर्गन ट्रांसप्लांट का और बनाया ग्रीन कॉरिडोर, जिसमें एयरपोर्ट से हॉस्पिटल का सफर जो घंटों का था उसे मिनटों का बना दिया। एम्बुलेंस फर्स्ट का डंका सिर्फ हिंदुस्तान में नहीं बल्कि न्यूयॉर्क तक बजा। रेडियो के ऑस्कर कहे जाने वाले न्यूयॉर्क फेस्टिवल ने एम्बुलेंस फर्स्ट इनिशिएटिव को दो बार NYF अवार्ड से नवाजा। और फिर कैंसर सर्वाइवर्स की जिंदगी में बदलाव लाने के लिए फीवर वॉइस ऑफ चेंज के साथ जुड़े युवराज सिंह।
फीवर वॉइस ऑफ चेंज के साथ कैंसर सर्वाइवर की जिंदगी के बदलाव के लिए मैं युवराज सिंह तैयार हूँ, क्या आप तैयार हैं?
फीवर वॉइस ऑफ चेंज ने वोटिंग परसेंटेज में किया बदलाव अपनी मुहिम ईच वन खींच वन के साथ।
नमस्कार, मैं हूँ फीवर आरजे अमिताभ बच्चन। चुनाव का माहौल बना हुआ, मैं तो कहूँगा कि ईच वन खींच वन। जब मैं भी वोटिंग करने जाऊँगा तो किसी को साथ खींच कर लेकर जाऊँगा।
इंडियन आर्मी के साथ मिलकर फीवर वॉइस ऑफ चेंज ने एक ऐसा जश्न मनाया जिसका शोर बॉर्डर पार पहुँचा।
मैं गौतम गंभीर।
मैं हूँ कर्नल VN थापर, कैप्टन विजयन थापर का फादर।
मैं हूँ मेजर गौरव आर्या।
फीवर FM के साथ मिलकर कहता हूँ,
इस कारगिल विजय दिवस मिलकर ऐसा जश्न मनाएंगे
कि शोर शोर
बॉर्डर पार पहुँचे। जय हिंद,
जय हिंद,
जय हिंद,
जय हिंद।
7th December इंडियन आर्म्ड फोर्स फ्लैग डे पर फीवर वॉइस ऑफ चेंज के साथ पूरे हिंदुस्तान ने मिलकर दिखाया अपना देश प्रेम।
मैं सिर्फ यही रिक्वेस्ट करना चाहूंगा सारे अपने फैंस और लिसनर्स से, आप फेसबुक हो चाहे इंस्टाग्राम हो चाहे इवन ट्विटर हो, अगर आप अपना फ्रेम चेंज कर सकते हैं 7 December को तो कहीं ना कहीं आप रिस्पेक्ट दे रहे हैं आर्म फोर्सेस को।
दिल्ली की बिगड़ती हवा और पॉल्यूशन से एनवायरनमेंट को बचाने के लिए फीवर वॉइस ऑफ चेंज लेकर आया प्रोजेक्ट ग्रीन हार्ट्स, जहां हमने दिल्ली NCR में लगाए 1,00,000 से भी ज्यादा पेड़।
आप पहले एक या दो पेड़ों से शुरुआत करो और कोशिश करो कि उन पेड़ों को अपने बच्चों की तरह बड़ा करो।
पुलवामा अटैक इस मुश्किल की घड़ी में पूरे देश को शहीदों के परिवार से जोड़ रही थी एक वेबसाइट भारत के वीर।
भारत के वीर
तो फीवर वॉइस ऑफ चेंज के साथ मिलकर सुपरस्टार अक्षय कुमार ने फीवर 104 FM पर DG CRPF से कहा,
हेलो
डी साहब शरद।
हाँ नमस्कार।
नमस्कार अक्षय भाई, मेरे साथ दूसरी लाइन पे।
नमस्ते जी, मेरे लायक कोई भी सेवा हो मैं बोला पूरा देश आपके साथ है इस वक्त। अभी आई हैव जस्ट सेंट 5 crore rupees टू भारत के वीर फ्रॉम माय साइड।
फीवर वॉइस ऑफ चेंज ने शुरू की मुहिम #सिंगल यूज प्लास्टिक से ब्रेकअप।
मैं तो सभी दुकानदारों से आग्रह करूंगा, आप अपने दुकान पर हमेशा बोर्ड लगाते हैं, एक बोर्ड ये भी लगा दीजिए, कृपा करके हमसे प्लास्टिक की थैली की अपेक्षा न करें।
और फिर पहली बार देश के किसी मीडिया हाउस की पीठ थपथपाने के लिए देश के प्रधानमंत्री श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी ने फीवर 104 FM के लिए ट्वीट किया। फीवर वॉइस ऑफ चेंज के पिछले 5 सालों की ये तो बस एक छोटी सी झलक थी, लेकिन फीवर वॉइस ऑफ चेंज की टीम जॉन इब्राहिम के साथ कहती है, ये बस शुरुआत है, बदलाव अब भी बाकी है।
Hi, this is Fever FM Chennai's RJ Sanu and this is 100 Hours, 100 Stars. The legends, the superstars, the who's who are all coming together to say Nandri, to say thank you and to salute our COVID warriors. I'm sure you're going to like this. So like, share, subscribe and spread the joy.
All right, welcome back to 100 Hours, 100 Stars, and this is a small effort by 94.3 Radio 1, Fever FM and Radio Nasha to raise awareness and funds for the COVID-19 frontline warriors. We have QR codes everywhere on the screen where you can go ahead and scan and contribute towards the PM Care funds, and I would suggest that everybody do that as much as possible in their own capacity and to actually entertain us through and through. We've got the one and only Ananya Birla. Ananya, how are you doing? Okay, first of all, let me tell everybody that this is Ananya Birla's t-shirt. Not literally her t-shirt from her closet, But this is merchandise while she was promoting her song. Ananya, tell us about this design. Tell us about this t-shirt, first of all.
Yeah, firstly, hello everyone. And thanks for having me. What you guys are doing, it's absolutely amazing. Yeah, thank you. And our frontline warriors, you know, they do a big thank you to all of them as well. So this t-shirt, it says, I circle you. This is for my song, Circles. This was kind of, I remember coming up with this line because we normally say, I heart you, but I love you. And then I was like, oh, maybe we can change the heart into a circle for the song. So people can say, I circle you, you know. So all the tight fans always say, I circle you to me. And it's just such a sweet sort of thing that only we know. Like, it's cute. It's like a thing. So thank you so much for wearing the t-shirt.
Yeah, free merchandise. Why wouldn't I wear it? All right. Ananya, it's been a couple of weeks after we spoke to you. We got to understand, what is the situation like there in LA? How are you doing in this lockdown? How is everybody around you in this lockdown?
Yeah, so personally for me, I am anyways quite introverted. I am anyways quite a homebody. So it hasn't been as tough for me as it has for many other people that I know. I'm also very comfortable. I love where I am. I'm making new music every single day. I'm creating. So it's not been that tough for me. You know, I've gotten time to actually create music without having a deadline, for example. I'm working out, I'm meditating, I'm connecting with friends who I haven't connected with for years. So it's been, I'm trying to look at the positives. It's still a little bit tough when you need to wrap your head around the new reality. But other than that, it's been fine. You know, I feel terrible for the ones suffering, but doing all I can to give back. So that's what it is. Currently for me in LA, like I was telling you earlier, it's like a soft lockdown. I don't know how to explain it. So it's like there's social distancing, but everything is still kind of happening. Of course, like clubs, bars, restaurants are closed, but you can get takeout, for example. Uber is still running. So that says a lot. But I've been at home, straight up. I've been self-isolating, self-quarantined. So it's just what it is. And beaches are closed, I think. Santa Monica Pier is closed. So it's pretty much all closed. It's just not as tight as India. But I think what India has done has been amazing. And that's what the rest of the world needs to do.
Yeah, we need to follow our lead this time. This is something epic. And I'm really happy about this.
Yeah.
So, Ananya, you are a millennial. You are someone who's been vocal about mental health as well. And this kind of a situation puts a toll, especially on the newer millennials who've just started working out, who've just started going to offices.
Yeah.
So how are you dealing with this so that they can find a little bit of inspiration on like the most basic level? What are you doing every single day to, you know, keep yourself sane and, you know, keep yourself occupied so that you can just, you know, sail through this time?
Yeah. Exactly what you said. It's all about being productive. We can't let this time take over us or our lives. We have to continue to do what we always do. So for me personally, music, I make new songs every day. Producers are still working from their homes. Virtual session with writers, it's still all very possible. Working out really helps me personally. It releases happy hormones. And then, you know, it's just nice, you know, self-care, relaxing, staying in bed a little bit more, reading more, watching Netflix. I think one more thing that I would like to say is that everyone is in the same boat. So for people who are just starting off at work, you're not missing out. You're not kind of going backwards in any way, because it's not on you. This is what the situation is. Everyone is in the same situation. We're all in the same boat. So just have to take it like that and know that it's going to pass. And it's just a different reality. And just, you know, have to adjust a little bit to it.
That's such a nice thing to say. It's like a reality and you got to adjust. And we are all in the same boat. That makes so much sense, Ananya. So let's talk about your new projects. I mean, I know that you'd like to keep things under wraps. And only once it's done, you would like to release this. But assuming that you almost completed 99.9% of your work, I think people are entitled to know slightly a little bit more about your new projects that you've been working on, your new collaborations and your dream collaborations. So let's start with the later ones. Let's start with your dream collaborations. Who are the artists that you're looking forward to collaborate with?
There are so many amazing artists, especially now that I'm signed with Maverick. There are so many opportunities. There's so much work that's been going on behind the scenes. It's truly been a very humbling, hardworking sort of journey. And there's so much coming up. So my dream would be like a Khalid, for example. I love Khalid. Of course, yes. Eminem, I love. Different people. So Lil Nas as well. I collaborated with Sean, which was really fun for the day goes by. So collaborations are always nice. But I think what we're going to be dropping first is new original music.
Yep.
And then collaborations or features once that's sort of going. My sound has changed quite a bit. It has a little bit more of an R&B touch. And yeah. A little bit of, like, when we hear it, we'll be able to say, oh, like, that's an Indian instrument. But it's done in a very subtle, very very classy manner. So it just sounds very cool to the ears. So that's then certain songs, like, you know, all my songs are very authentic, so that's there. But I've been bluntly honest in all my songs. So experiences I've had, people are going to be calling me saying, is this a song about me? Like, it's going to happen in the past. It's probably going to happen loads for the music coming up. So
you're going the kamikaze way, right? You're going to be calling out a lot of people out there.
I mean, that's one thing about being my friend or whatever. Like, I will write about you if you inspire me or if you bother me in any way.
That's literally such a millennial thing to do, man. Calling out people. That's what our life is all about. We love doing that, don't we?
I mean, but not in a... I would never put names out there. I would never sort of jeopardize anyone. It's just how my emotions for that particular situation. It's just that person would know, or those people would know, because they have been in the situation as well. That's pretty
nice. That's nice. That's really nice. Let's talk about your connection to Eminem. All right, you're like a big fan of Eminem. So how did that happen? Like a girl doing R&B music, singing happy songs, talking about circles and love and falling and holding on. How do you like Eminem? How did that Eminem fan, you know, that energy translate into your own music? How did that happen?
I'm just in love with Slim Shady and everything he does. You know, I think his entire story that he sort of grew up in the ghetto and he was the only sort of white man in that sort of rap zone to kind of make it, and the discrimination he went through, you know, it can't possibly be easy. And that, you know, I've watched the movie as well, and it's just that rap battle. I don't know whether you see at the very end.
Everybody in the country.
Yes. And then I just love how authentic he is with music. He, like, even names people. Like, that's, like, next level. He's just so authentic. And I think Mockingbird is a song that... It's probably one of my favorite songs.
Nice. That's really nice. That's good for you.
Lose Yourself is a very nice song. Beautiful is a very nice song. I think he has something about him. He's just unapologetic, you know? He is, I am who I am. And also his entire journey with... Addiction is a mental struggle as well. It's a mental illness as well. And so I guess he's gone through that also. So that's very commendable that he's now sober for decades. So that's very inspiring. So I think just as a human being and then as a musician, he kind of inspires me.
That's wonderful. Having inspirations really... So apart from Eminem, who other people inspire you in your music and in your life?
I think different people inspire me for different reasons. Like... For example, my best friend inspires me because she's super selfless. Like, she's been cooking for me. She cleans. Because I've been, like, waking up, getting in the studio, writing music. Like, I told you, I was up till 4 a.m. So she always brings me snacks, food. She makes sure that the house is clean. I'm in quarantine with her. So she inspires me to be more selfless, for example. My mom inspires me in terms of just how she carries herself off and how she can take care of three really... kids who can be bad, no, we're good, we're fine. And plus, My dad inspires me for other reasons. And then, you know, there are different people out there in the world that the Obamas really inspire me. Martin Luther King Jr. really still inspires me. A couple of my close friends inspire me, like Sanya inspires me a lot, you know.
That's nice.
So, like, different people inspire me for different reasons. I don't think there's, like, that there's one person who, like, inspires me. Beyonce inspires me so much. Like, I can keep taking names for an hour, but I don't have, like, one particular person.
That's really nice. That's really nice. Okay. Ananya, before we can actually start singing, when I say we, I mean her, not me. I'm not going to sing. I've got a small game. I've got two games you can choose. Okay. All right. One is called the Lockdown Bingo. I will list a couple of things that you could have probably done in this bingo, in this lockdown.
Yeah.
All right. And if I guess a couple of them right, I win, of course. And if I don't, you got to tell me what you've done. All right.
Okay.
So it's fairly a simple game. So what we do is I will read out a couple of things. You just got to tell me whether you've done that or not.
Okay.
Have you made a Dalgona coffee sitting there in LA because that was the biggest trend in India?
No, I have not because I don't drink coffee.
Ah. So instead of the coffee, did you make anything which was like a nice cool beverage for you?
I just love my masala chai, so I just drink that all day.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, where is your chai? Isn't it like the morning chai time?
No, I just had chai before
that. Oh damn. Okay. Have you done video calls or video conferences with your colleagues and your partners? By just being formal on the top and informal on the bottom.
Yeah. Always. Today I'm wearing I'm not wearing pajamas. I'm still casual, the track pants, but I always do that. I just wear a shirt or a t-shirt and I'm just in my, it's awesome.
All right. Have you played either Ludo or Uno or Words with Friends while you're in quarantine on your phone?
I have played Connect Four and Chess on my phone with my friends. So if that counts.
Yes, that counts because there are different applications that I might not be aware of. But yeah, that counts. Okay. Have you made a TikTok video which was like a viral video? Have you done the savage dance or have you done something which you haven't uploaded or you uploaded?
I did flip the switch. That was kind of funny. Yeah. That did really well actually. So yes, I have made. I did with Lata. So it was actually quite funny. Have you seen it?
We all saw that. So that's there. Okay. Have you actually lost time at home? Like you went in on a Monday but then came back after the Thursday. You know, did that happen to you?
I do. I feel like time is a construction. Like I have no idea sometimes. Yeah. Like what is today? Friday? Saturday?
I mean, it's somewhere close. I mean, it's right there.
Yeah, I mean, I try to keep a tab because like it's like my schedule. Like this is on this day. It's actually really funny how there's so much going on. It's weird. Like it's cool. So I kind of know, but I kind of lose a lot of track. I lose track as well. Like, I know what you're saying. Yeah. So I'm
okay. Yeah. Okay. Last question. Have you absolutely done nothing for one day and just said, today is the day when I'm going to be Bruno Mars and not do any?
Yeah, totally. I watched Too Hot to Handle. I binge-watched it the entire day one day. So I woke up, I worked out, and then but that still counted as not doing anything.
Yeah.
So I was in bed the whole day and I was just watching Too Hot to Handle. I don't even think I checked my phone that day. I think my parents got worried thinking something happened to me when I'm just sitting and watching Too Hot to Handle. And then when it was bedtime, I just changed my clothes. Like I changed to different pajamas. I quickly had a shower again and then I just went back to sleep.
What a brilliant day, Ananya. What a brilliant day. That would have been really cool. Okay. So yes, I did guess a lot of those things that happened.
You did. You did actually.
Well, I technically do win. You all did. Right.
Yeah. I agree you win.
So I think I'm entitled to a couple of your tracks because yes. I think people are waiting for this. I mean, nobody wants to listen to me jabbering and talking. I mean, they want to listen.
I'll play on my guitar.
Sure.
I'll play circles, maybe a little bit of circles.
Yep.
I tuned it this morning, so. Can you see me?
Yes, I can see you.
Remember all the early days, yeah. Staying up at 3 a.m., yeah. Falling out of love together. And thinking it will last forever. Been through everything you've said. The worst of me, you never, ever, ever, ever let me down. This is part of our body. Never start, I'm gonna be the one I'm singing about. Only you don't know. Without you, I'll be running in circles, running in circles. It's true, it's true. No matter the hurdles, I'll always be the one to take the fall. The fall, the fall. Remember all the time. Saying let's seize the moments when we wake up tomorrow. Aniket, and you've seen the worst of me. You never, ever, ever let me down. This is part of our body. Never scarred, I'm gonna be the one to say this loud. One you don't know. Without you, I'll be running in circles, running in circles. It's true, no matter the hurdles, I'll always be the one to take the fall.
Yeah, that's good. That's good, Ananya. Thank you so much. Okay, while we are actually continuing the conversation, I would just like to remind people.
Would you cut it there?
Sure.
You know where I went wrong with the call? Just cut it there.
I will. Don't worry.
Okay, amazing. Thanks.
Yeah. So I'll actually keep this footage also right there in the video, and I'll put it in the description so that they know that they have to snip it there.
Yeah, perfect.
All right. Okay. So let me remind people once again, that's Ananya Birla. And this is 100 Hours, 100 Stars. Why we are actually trying to raise funds for people who are fighting on the front lines for COVID-19, of course. So QR codes on the screen. All you got to do is scan it as quickly as you can from your phone cameras and go ahead and pay and contribute as much as you can. So Ananya, apart from making your own music, you know, you would have started somewhere. You would have started covering a certain artist somewhere, right?
Yeah.
So let's go a little back in time and figure out who was that first artist that you started covering and singing songs of, and then, you know, went into your originals.
So this is very unexpected, but I used to sing Wind Beneath My Wings by Bette Midler. So that was one song that I used to sing through like school, high school, like the band and all that stuff. And then I used to sing a lot of Poker Face by Lady Gaga. I've got a very unusual Zombie by the Cranberries. Like I've got very like unusual songs for some reason. So yeah, these three I think are on my top. I don't even know whether they're like commercially very like out there, but these three songs possibly, yeah.
I thought you would have been more Evanescence and Linkin Park, you know?
Linkin Park, like Indie and Numb and all, like all of that stuff anyways. Like karaoke is different, but I have never like... Yeah, I mean like all of that also, like when I start rapping Eminem stuff, like it really depends. But if you ask me like three songs, like I would say like I did these three the most.
You know, you keep on bringing rapping while we are having a conversation, and I'm very compelled, and I'm very like right there on the edge to ask you to give me like a bar or a verse. All right. So, you know, I don't know, you could say no to this, but then is there a verse or a rap verse that you could just give me, like randomly from probably Lose Yourself? That's absolutely all right.
What's the Mummy's Pasta one? Is it Lose Yourself? I've heard so many of Eminem's stuff now.
What, Mummy's Pasta?
Yeah, the spaghetti.
Yeah, that's Mom's Spaghetti. That's Lose Yourself.
That's Lose Yourself, right?
Yeah.
I know all of these. Let me just pull the lyrics out so I make sure that I'm
ready. Yeah, the lyrics are confusing. The songs are super simple. That's the problem with Eminem.
I love him. Let me see if I can. I'm going to try to do it. If I can't, then just cut that out.
Sure. Let's just do it just do the most simplest thing, you know?
Yeah. So, look, if you had one shot, okay. Let's do this. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy, that's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's joking now, everybody's joking now. The clock run out, time's up, oh, now slap back to reality. Oh, there goes gravity, oh, there goes gravity. He's so mad, but he won't give up that, as you know, he won't have it. Lose yourself in the music, the moment you own it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss a chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime, yo.
You know, you are literally mood for every single person right now. You know? Like, Ananya Birla is absolute mood. This is going to be like the snippet of my video highlight. You know, Ananya Birla trying M&M's Lose Yourself. This is going to be absolute mad. Because this is something that you need to go ahead and do a little outside your comfort zone, but making yourself happy.
Totally. I agree. Can you do me a favor? Can you cut it and start from when I got into it, where I started? I think I started from...
Yeah.
You wrote down, the whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. You want me to do it again, or you got it?
We got it. We'll do it from there only. So the first few bits, we're going to just chop it up, and then we're going to...
Yeah, perfect.
All right. Okay, Ananya, we're coming towards the end of the conversation. It was absolutely fantastic. 25 minutes that we had.
It's been a lot of fun.
Yes. So, quick question. What is the first thing that you want to do the minute this gets over? Is it something that you want to eat? Someone you want to meet? You did speak about your parents earlier. So, is that still?
It's been like 10 months since I've been home, like in Bombay. So, I'm probably, hopefully the borders are shut. So, hopefully that'll open up and I can give them a big hug. But otherwise, I'm very happy here, and you know, I think it's good because I have my music and I'm working on that. So good stuff happening. But yeah, give my parents a big hug.
That's again, Ananya Birla is mood. Everybody is mood right now. The ones that they're missing are the ones that are going to get the biggest hug ever. So right there, Ananya, thank you so much for being a part of this journey. Thank you so much for being here, entertain us, speak about yourself, speak about your life, and be an open book. This really means a lot. I circle you. That's right there.
I circle you. Thank you so much, Aniket. You're so awesome, honestly. I love Radio 1. I've already told you this 1,000 times. I'm not going to say it again. Yes. Thank you for this amazing initiative, and thank you so much for having me on board. And guys, the QR codes are on, so I hope y'all donate. Y'all know what's good. If y'all are ever in need, then everyone who you are helping will also help you. So, what goes around comes around. Please do your bit.
All right. This is 100 Hours, 100 Stars. And that was the one and only Ananya Birla. Ananya, thank you so much. You take care.
Appreciate you. Thank you. Bye.
Hello friends, fans and listeners of Radio 1, Fever FM and Radio Nasha. I'm Vikram Moses from Radio 1 Chennai. Hope you're having a great time watching all the great content on our social media handles. It's filled with stars, superstars and legends, of course, all your favorite people. So if you actually like all the content, don't forget to hit the like button, the subscribe button, of course. Don't forget to leave your comments right below. But right now, continue watching. Have a great time.
Presenting Fever Network, the power of three. Number one station in Delhi, Mumbai, Bangalore and Kolkata. Fever FM, the bomb of Bollywood.
Congratulations to all of you for being the number one radio station.
The biggest CSR initiative on radio. Pioneers of radio drama in the industry. Sports tie-ups, official radio partners of five winning IPL teams. Most entertaining shows and RJs. India's coolest retro station. 107.2 Radio Nasha. 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 Gaane ka nasha, gungunaane ka nasha, sunne ka nasha, suna. Celebrities. Best of retro. Shows and RJs that take you back in time. Radio 1, India's only international network. The only radio station Katy Perry vibed with. We were there when U2 performed for the first time in India. Global teen sensation Justin Bieber jams with Radio 1. Truly global shows and RJs. Mega Mix. America's Top 40, The Mahindra Blues Show, and more.
hello, this is RJ Raghuraftar from Lucknow. Hope you guys are enjoying 100 hours, 100 stars. The list is jam-packed with superstars and legends. So just stay tuned, and what you like, just don't forget to share. Please like, share, comment and subscribe if you're watching on YouTube and Facebook also. Do comment, share with your friends and family if you're watching on Instagram. Hi, hello to everyone. Just stay connected, stay tuned and stay entertained.